Did you ever create your own holes to fish in? And I'm not talking about building a pond or a lake. I'm talking about creating your own holes to fish in. Good morning, guys and girls. July 27. Seems like that something's going on. Have I got a meeting or something important going on today? Or what is July 27? I was married in December 30, so it couldn't have been that. Okay, happy birthday to my beautiful wife, Chris. She is today turning... Well, I'm not even going to say what her age is today. I quit saying that a long time ago. I have learned that the longest 10 years in a woman's life is between 29 and 30. Another time that 10 years takes a long time is between 39 and 40. And I think that continues as they continue on. I don't know. But today, Chris is... I'm not about to tell you. She is younger than me. I'll just put it that way. She is younger than me. And by the way, she's my first wife. If we make it till December, and I know that's an old song, if we make it till December, we will have been married 57 years. 57 years. Okay, July 27. Let's look in Zephaniah. Zephaniah 2:7. The Lord their God will pay attention to them, and he'll make their life good again. Let's change that around a little bit. The Lord your God will pay attention to you, and he'll make your life good again. The Lord my God will pay attention to me, and he'll make my life good again. Let's see what I wrote about that. It's frustrating to go stretches when you can't get a bite. You can't catch a fish. Maybe you get one or two little ones. If you fish tournaments, these stretches can quickly turn into an entire day. One or two bites, one or two fish. Then might they turn into 2 days. And then you might go several tournaments where you just can't catch a check. You just can't catch quite enough to get in the money. Those are bad stretches. Those are the times that you just think nothing will ever go right. But Zephaniah 2:7 says that God is paying attention to you. Life, relationships, and business seem to throw those same stretches at us. The devil has a way of jumping in and piling on. One problem leads to another. Troubles seem to come in bunches. It comes from all directions, all around us, you know, everywhere we turn. We wake up sometimes, and I've gone through a stretch where I woke up in the morning, thought the best thing I could do is slice my wrist. That's how bad things were going. When it looks like there's no way out, that's when we need God the most. And that's when God is at his very best. That's when God will step in and walk on water. That's when God will step in and show out and show off and perform those miracles that God's in the business of doing. That's when we don't need to pray. We have to pray. That's when we don't just read God's word. We immerse ourselves in it and we live in it. I've seen God walk on water many, many times in my life, and I'm counting on him to do it again. No matter what you're going through, no matter what kind of problems you have, business problems, family problems, children problems, church problems, whatever you're going through, health problems, God's paying attention. God's paying attention, and God's going to step in and make your life good again. All right, let's see what we got written down here for our tip. Here's our tip. Create your own holes in heavy vegetation to fish later in the day. Create your own holes in heavy vegetation to fish later in the day. That's right. This is an old trick I learned down in Florida. I was down in Florida fishing, and I saw a guy, and I looked over, and he had a hoe in his boat, a rake and a hoe in his boat. And I said, those are funny-looking rod and reels, dude. And he said, well, I'm going to make me a few holes to fish later in the day. And I said, what you talking about? And he said, I'm going to go out there in some of that real heavy stuff that you can't get down through. And we didn't have these big titanium slip sinkers back in those days where you can punch down through that. And so I said, what are you talking about? He said, I'm going to make some holes. I'm going to dig me out a hole with that rake and that hoe, and then I'm going to go back and fish it later in the day where that hole is. And I said, my gosh, that's a great idea. And that is a tournament secret that we learned years and years ago. Very few people shared that with any other people. Very few people even know about it today. As an example, though, if you look over there and you'll see that point coming out there, What you're seeing on top of the water, that kind of looks like yellow stuff laying on top of the water. That's where coontail moss has grown up and laid over on top. And the lake's going down a little bit because it's summertime, and it's left that really, really thick. Now, we can fish frogs over the top of it. We can take the heavy slip sinkers we have nowadays and punch down through the middle of it. But you can also make a few holes, little small holes, that will stay open for a few days and go back and fish those holes later in the day. It's a great way to do it. Guys and girls, go out there and have you a great one today. Happy, happy birthday to my beautiful wife, Chris. I sure hope she cooks me a big old steak tonight. Have a great one out there today. And remember, I love you.